Coming to you live from the Big Brother backyard, it's Rob Has a Podcast, and now the guy who's a little pissed. I'm Rob Sesternino. Hello, everybody. Welcome to our coverage of the Big Brother 18 finale. Here I am. We are in the Big Brother backyard. This was the site of the final three competition. You could see our winner in the background behind me. She's like on Snapchat or on the phone or something like that. Still, that's what winners do. They're always working. And Nicole was your winner here of Big Brother 18. Very surprising outcome. Once Paul won that final HOH, everybody thought he had it, won the game, but a shocking decision to take Nicole to the final two. And history was made as the first time ever in a Big Brother final two, a man has lost to a woman 5-4. We are going to do our best to get you interviews and talk with every single person from this damn season. We're going to try to get them all here for you on video and in the audio version of this podcast. If you want to see the video of this, go to our YouTube channel, robhasawebsite.com/YouTube. For the audio version, stick right here. You could hear all of our Survivor coverage. Plus, Jordan Parhar is going to have his full recap with the LFC, the live feed correspondence, also on the website and on our iTunes page. Go to robhasawebsite.com/iTunes for all of that. So without further ado, let's get into our interviews with the cast of Big Brother 18 here in the backyard. Very excited here at the Big Brother 18 finale. We're here with the amazing host of Big Brother, Julie Chen. Julie, how are you?
I'm doing very well.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Julie, of course, we're all down with OTT.
Oh, yes. It's like the song.
OPP, yes. Yes.
Down, you're down with OTT. Yes.
Yeah.
Over the top.
Yes.
CBS All Access. You must subscribe if you want to watch the next season of Big Brother. It's going to be 12 brand new house guests that you're going to grow to love and hate.
Yes.
And a returner, the 13th member, you guys get to vote, but you have to subscribe to vote. It's going to be either Jose or Jason from last year.
So we're so excited, but we have so many questions about how the format is going to work. I know it premieres a week from tonight, but what are we going to be seeing on OTT?
You are going to be seeing, instead of nomination ceremonies, we're doing safety ceremonies on Saturdays and Sundays.
Okay.
The house guests will gather around and they want to hear their name called out, because if it's called out, they're safe. The key thing with CBS All Access, Big Brother OTT, is 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 o'clock Pacific, 7 days a week. That's the key time to tune in when you're not watching around the clock, because you're either going to see an update of what's been happening, or a safety ceremony on the weekends, or on Wednesday nights, you're going to see a recap of the whole week leading up to the live eviction. And Thursdays, you're going to see my eviction interview.
Okay. I know you announced tonight that America was going to decide the winner. Is America going to be deciding who goes home week to week?
America will be deciding more than just the winner. I can't get into specifics.
Okay.
You need to watch. They're going to control a lot of the game.
Yeah. Do you feel like that the OTT season is going to be crazier than the normal Big Brother season that we're used to?
I think it will be crazier because, you know, with the CBS version, you get 1 hour of me like talking to them. They know they're live on the satellite to, you know, all of America. With OTT, it's going to feel a lot more intimate because they're not going to, you know, hear the clapping live audience. So I think they're going to really let loose.
Were you happy with Nicole's win over Paul in the final two?
Yes. You know what? With Paul or Nicole winning in the final two, I can make an argument for each one to win it. So, and being a woman, to win it for the first time against
a guy,
you know what? I tip my hat to her.
Julie, thank you so much for a great season. Are you ready for another OTT season?
Chenbot is always ready.
Yes.
Chenbot does not sleep.
Recharge those batteries, Julie.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much for coming on. I appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Okay. All right. We're here with the winner of Big Brother 18. How does that sound, Nicole? Holy crap.
Holy crap.
Yeah. Wow.
Insane.
Look at you.
Insane.
You did it.
I did it.
You did it. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations. What a crazy ride it was for you.
Yeah.
Because I don't think at any point anybody said, you know, Nicole's got this game on lockdown.
No.
At any point.
No.
But then it was like, but you know, I think that there was always like respect of like, okay, well, you know, Nicole has done a good job of staying off of the block.
Yeah.
And here she is. And then Paul says he wants to go to the final two with you instead of James.
Yep.
And we're like, what are you doing? This is not a good plan.
I honestly thought Paul could be, no matter who he took, I thought he was going to win.
Yeah.
It did come down very close. It just depended if the jury was going to vote emotionally or strategically, and you don't know. You have no idea what kind of jury it's going to be.
Yeah. Can you talk about what it's like for you? You talked about as a person. I know that Meech is the super fan, so I don't know that you just as a lifelong fan. I don't know.
I'm a lifelong fan.
A lifelong fan of the game.
I mean, I've been a fan forever.
So what is that like for you to now be a winner of this game? And there's only 18, and we don't even really count Big Brother 1.
It's an absolute dream come true. Just to play this game again and have the opportunity to try to, like, you know, prove yourself one more time that you know what you're doing in this game. It was awesome, and I just cannot believe that I actually won. Like, you know, I fought hard, but I can't believe it actually is a reality now.
Yeah. What do you feel like? I know you talked about that the biggest move you made was that move at the final 7.
Yep.
Where ultimately we had that scene where Paulie came out and was like saying to Paul and to...
No, not that scene. No, I said my biggest move in the game was when Paulie was out of the house.
Right, but right before he went out, that he said, like, okay, look, there's two people, and then you went back and relayed that information to Natalie.
Yeah, I planted
and said,
a seed.
Hey, you planted that seed.
I planted that seed.
Right, and that was
strategic. Trust me, if she won HOH, I needed to be prepared.
Well, that was good because it really did look like that you guys were dead in the water where Paulie went
literally
out.
That is literally the move that changed. That is literally what saved me. Literally, me going, when I went pee talking to Natalie, saved me and Corey that week.
Wow.
Isn't that crazy? One little tiny thing. I was amazed. I looked back on it and I was like, you know, we dodged the block because I said one tiny sentence at this time?
Yeah. It's crazy.
Oh.
It's crazy. So in terms of comparing yours, like where you came from in Big Brother 16 and watching Derek play, do you feel like that you took a lot of things from Derek and used them in this game?
I definitely took some things from Derek. You know, you got to have some kind of benefit for playing this game before. And I was very good at making people think that it was their idea on things and acting like, that's a good idea. But I would definitely kind of steer them towards that, if that makes sense. And I watched Derek do that, and I did it on day two to Corey, convincing me to let me have the first HOH.
Yeah. So let's talk about Corey and what's going on here. I know it's getting called out here. You're right?
Yeah.
All right. So I know everybody probably has a lot of questions. You know, that this is what happens when you get out of Big Brother. People are going to ask you a bunch of questions about relationship status.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. So do you feel like that does winning the game change anything?
No. Like, change anything for what? My life?
Yeah. Well, now it's like, well, now you're...
Oh, that.
Now
that,
you have,
that,
like,
that. Okay,
maybe
so
you have
more
options
I'm
now, Nicole.
I'm more financially stable.
Yeah, more financially stable.
Like, definitely stuff like that, yeah.
Yeah, but it doesn't change anything with Corey.
No.
Okay. Have you guys talked about what's going on here?
No, we have not talked about it.
Okay, well, now you could fly him around.
Yeah, I could.
You could.
I could.
But definitely on the table.
I know he's a busy guy, too, but I think he's a great guy, and we will see what happens.
Okay. So in terms of any of the other players from the season, is there anybody that you feel like that you have bad blood with, like Big Meech? That do you feel like that she seemed like she really...
She hates me.
She really does. And I don't know what ultimately happened. Like, what was the
only thing that ever happened was I voted Davon out. And did not tell her prior.
Yes.
That's it.
Do you feel like, is that relationship salvageable?
She has not told me congratulations, has not made eye contact with me, has not said one thing. So we will see. I mean, I'm more than willing to be nice to anybody, but I'm not going to, you know, sit here and be treated like crap in the room. If I don't need to be around someone that's not
right,
nice.
You're the winner. You're the winner. You're you know, it's probably on her. Because you really never had that big a beef with her.
I mean,
you might have wanted to target her and get her out of the game.
It was simply strategic.
Yes.
Nothing personal.
Nothing
ever.
Personal.
Never called her a name or anything like that.
Yeah. All right, so, Nicole, can you believe there's going to be another Big Brother season that starts in a week?
Oh, that's crazy. I cannot believe it. Like, what is going on?
Yes, BBOTT.
What is it over the top? Was it, like, what is it?
Yeah, that's what it is.
Is it brand new house guests?
You know, it's a new house guest and Jose, who really, the prophecy of the season, that watch out for Snake Hull, he said it, but he was the Messiah.
Nobody listened to him.
Yeah, that was a prophecy, and nobody listened. And now he could be back.
Yeah.
He has a 50-50 chance to come back for BBOTT.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's crazy.
That is crazy.
It's crazy. I know that your buddy Andy Heron is so pumped up that you are ultimately able to do it. Do you feel like that? Are you a better winner than Andy?
I don't think I'm a better winner than I'm not gonna say I'm not better than anybody. So.
Not better than anybody.
No.
So if we had 18 Big Brother winners, Nicole.
We can put
Nicole
me at the bottom. That's
18.
Fine. That's fine.
No, that's not true.
I don't know. I haven't even got to reflect on my game yet. I don't know where I stand. I'm just privileged to even be. In this position.
Hey, don't go pageant on me, Nicole.
I'm not going pageant on you. This is honestly how I feel. Like, yeah. I don't, to be considered among, like, the BB greats, it's very crazy. I don't know.
Well,
I'm not
going to
rank myself.
Carried away, Nicole.
I'm not going to rank myself in any, you know.
Yeah. All right. We'll leave that for the off-season podcast. But anyway, Nicole, congratulations. I'm happy for you. It was very nice to see a woman beat a man in the final two. It's been talked about for so many years now that it never was going to happen. Were you aware of that?
No,
that was a thing?
I did not know that was a thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So all the women Big Brother players are
saying, I'm
with her.
So all the other women were sitting next to women. That's insane. Did
yeah.
not know that statistic.
You are like a leader in the feminist movement.
Wow.
You've done it for women everywhere.
Woo!
No, in all seriousness, though, congratulations.
Thank you.
Job well done, and all the best. Go get some rest
Thank
after
you.
99 hard-fought days.
Yes. Thank
right.
you.
Nice to meet you, Nicole.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Bye. All right, we're here with. Your boy, my boy.
Oh,
pissed.
What up? So pissed.
Pissed.
Not actually
what?
Not that pissed.
No, pissed. Nah. I'm pissed. I'm
He's
pissed.
He's pissed. I'm not
pissed.
Pissed.
Sketch decision.
So sketch. Right?
So sketch.
Me? My sketch decision?
Yeah, you made sketch decision.
I blew
I think.
It, huh?
I
Whatever.
Think so.
I mean,
that was not friendship.
I thought I would have won either way, but clearly I blew it.
But you're over it?
Oh, I never cared. I'm
never
over
cared.
It.
Oh, never cared. Over it.
Toss it out the
well,
window.
We cared a lot.
Well, I like that.
Yeah. Paul, very excited. You really made this season very fun.
That's all I needed to hear.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
It was great. I heard you say with somebody else that you felt like you feel like America doesn't like you. Why? Because you didn't get a little basket?
I don't know. America didn't send me a package. I'm loud. I'm crazy. Yeah. I feel like America's like, who is this guy?
I can't speak to everybody. I can't speak to, like, you weren't in the top three for the fan voting. But for the people that we're talking to, your poll numbers are very good.
I like that. I like some solid poll numbers.
Yes. So talk to me about ultimately what ended up happening with that final two. Because I really felt like, you won that final HOH. There we go. This is going to be great. What a happy ending this is going to be for this story. But then ultimately, you wanted to take Nicole to the end. And you had been talking to her all week about this.
I mean, really, I was just prepping her the right way just in case she wants, because I knew she was the only one who was going to give me a run for my money. But clearly, I'm the better player because I have the most comp wins. But I don't know. I thought all my actions in the house spoke for themselves, and realistically, I thought I would win against anyone in the end, any of the people remaining in the final five or four in the end. But I was wrong. So never cared, and I would do it all over again. I would do the same thing. I would do it just as crazy.
No, do it different this time.
I would do it even crazier.
No, do it this
time. I'd do it even crazier.
So why not James? Why Nicole over James? Because you talked about that, like, James, you weren't honest with me. You were talking to Nicole. Were you being punitive with him, or were you setting something up?
I was kind of setting something up there.
Hey, I feel you're drifting. Get this closer.
Oh, I'm drifting. All right. I thought I was loud. I was kind of setting something up, but at the same time, there was some truth to that. James had made my game very difficult throughout the season. And at that point, I might have tossed in a little bit of emotion in that decision. But again, I was confident that my numbers, my statistics, my underdog story would have spoken for themselves. But there must have been a little bit of a bitter jury because I'm a little bit of an asshole. But I'll take it.
Yeah. Oh, it was all very fun to watch. Who was the vote that you didn't get that you thought you had?
I thought I had Day's vote. I really did. But I
did
guess
too.
She was still bitter about going out on my HOH. I thought she was rooting for me, but I was wrong.
Have you talked to her?
No. She'll probably chew me out later.
You think so?
Probably. She's just
so
as
you
crazy.
So you felt like you had it 5-4, and you feel like that Davon was the one vote that you didn't get?
I thought Davon was the vote that I was going to get, but it turns out I didn't, and...
Because you got James's vote. I
that
didn't
was
think
a little,
you were going to get James's
vote. Pulled a homie move because I think James saw how hard I worked, because I worked very hard, but I guess it just didn't work out in my favor. And as a first-time player of the game, I thought that should have spoken itself, that I made it this far. I was up against two vents in the end, and I still survived. But I guess it wasn't enough.
I thought you really, really did a great job in your speech. I thought that was
a very strong,
heartfelt. Maybe a little too long. Maybe like 10% too long. But that's a nitpick.
Yeah, I mean, I'm always too long. I'm always screaming too much. So.
Yeah. But really, I thought it was a really, really strong job. Now, I feel like that you came in here. You at the beginning, you didn't know what you were doing. To be fair.
I mean, all right, I didn't know. But you figured it out.
I definitely figured it out. Do you feel like that you're the kind of person that, I mean, you did a lot better in your first time than any of these people that came back this time. Do you feel like that there's another Big Brother trip in your future?
Yeah, I mean, I would love to take another tackle at the game, but I'm definitely not everyone's cup of tea, and I know that, so...
What would you change? What would you do differently?
I wouldn't change anything.
Yeah.
I literally would not change anything, because if I changed anything, people would be like, all right, what's up? I know this guy was crazy. Why is he not crazy anymore? Weird.
Yeah.
So I got to be, if not more crazy.
Yeah. Because I do think that people are so bored in this house.
Everyone's boring. Everyone's a weenie, and I called them out for it.
Yeah.
And maybe that's why they didn't vote for me, but it's cool. Because I walked out of here with my pride, stayed true to myself, never cared.
Yeah. Do you feel like that there's one decision before we got to this final two that you wish you had a do-over on?
Nope. I would do it all the same because I thought I was confident.
Yeah.
I mean, knowing that I would lose to Nicole, obviously I wouldn't take Nicole. But, I mean, dude, who did more than I did? Nobody in this house. And that's nobody can argue that anybody did more.
Is there anybody from this cast that you're not interested in seeing again after
75%
this?
75%
of them.
75%. A bunch of amateur crybabies.
Real?
A bunch of adult children. Coming from the guy who has a floaty around his waist, screams friendship, and does the most outlandish things, and the youngest player in the house, I could tell you that everybody in here was super immature. And not the brightest bulb in the box.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm a dick.
What happened to Pablo?
I don't know. Michelle took him, tossed him in the crowd.
No, we saw a shot. Your parents don't have him? They look like in the
someone
audience.
Someone has him. Yeah. Pablo, wherever you are, come back, buddy. I miss you.
All right. Are you going to watch this BBOTT? I heard you don't like BBOTT. I heard you weren't going to watch it.
Who said that? Over the top? I'm watching that.
You're watching that?
Hell yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Put me in that house.
That's great. Now, are you rooting for Jose to get back
in?
The Messiah?
Yes, the Messiah, the crazy MF-er. He needs to go in there and stir some drama because he makes some good TV, I'll tell you that.
Yes.
He's definitely a character.
Boy, I feel like there's a million other things to ask you. Will you come on and talk more about Big Brother and Big Brother OTT in the next couple of weeks?
Hell yeah, man. I mean, whenever...
Man,
look,
I do these podcasts in the Valley.
I live in the Valley.
It'd be like 15 minutes from you.
Yes.
Yeah.
Hook me up.
Yes.
Call me. Let's talk Big Brother all day long, but just give me like a few weeks to detox from all this craziness.
Okay, that's fine. What are you going to do next? You're trying to find a girlfriend now? You said
No, I'm not trying to find a girlfriend. But, I mean, if my future wife is out there, let's get married. I don't know. I'm going to invest in my creativity. I'm going to keep making music, keep making clothes, doing what I love, and hopefully people like it. And if not, they don't.
They don't like it. Okay. Paul, great to see you. Thank you so much for the
entertainment. Of course, man.
If you would have been voted out in the beginning, boy, I don't know how we would have got through this season.
Dang, that's really cool.
It didn't work out, but
it worked
really
out.
You kept it interesting, and
I'm glad.
There were points in this season, I think, where that was maybe the only thing that might have been really super interesting.
Thank you.
We were a lot of fans out there.
Thank you. I much love to all of you.
Yeah.
That shocked
friendship,
me.
Friendship.
Friendship all around.
Friendship
all around.
Yeah. All right, Paul. Thank you so much.
Absolutely,
all the best
buddy.
To you.
Cheers. Let's fuck that up again. All right. Cheers, guys.
All right, we're back with James. James finishes third place.
Oh.
You're right there, James.
Gut punch.
So talk about what ultimately ended up happening with Paul accused you of that you went back and you were talking to Nicole. Was that legit?
That's a bunch of malarkey, Rob.
Malarkey.
That's a bunch of malarkey. You know, in this game, you have to – I never inadvertently threw Paul under the bus. It was more or less, hey, if you win, like, you know – what do you feel like you would, you know, who you would take?
Yeah.
And just trying to get a feel for it. You know, I had to cover all my bases. I didn't want to be like, I'm just going to leave it all up to Paul. And then, you know, Nicole's like, you didn't even come talk to me as a Big Brother player.
Yeah.
Like, you know, that's like someone winning HOH and you're not even going to talk to him. You know?
Now, but you voted for Paul in the end. That was friendship. I think that most people in your position would said, hey, you took me out. You voted me out. You will not get my vote.
Yes.
Or were you more mad at Nicole because she threw you under the bus to Paul?
You know, yeah, I actually could look at that both ways.
Yeah. You got an extra grind with either of them.
Yeah, I know. I told him, I said, when I put my key in, before I put it in, I said, listen, it's still fresh, got a lot of emotions with both of you guys, but, you know, I was going to ultimately vote for whoever I felt like went through the game the hardest, who had to overcome a lot of obstacles. And, you know, like I said, Paul coming in week one, volume button broke at 10. He didn't know what a power veto was. He didn't know what a coup d'etat was. Didn't know what a Pandora's box was.
Yeah.
And now the kid's at final two, and he survived the block six times. I mean, and his social game, I always, in my mind, I'm like, that kid has got a great social game.
Mm-hmm.
He could talk to anybody.
Were you surprised that Natalie ended up voting for Nicole to win?
Actually, yes. Yes.
Because
yes.
that means a 5-4 vote. Any of those any of those Nicole votes swing, Paul's the winner.
Nicole, she was more worried about that with me. She said, if I take you to Final Two, I know I lost Natalie's vote. I know I lost Michelle's vote. Which, in that case, if I was up there, Natalie told me she would vote for me if I was up there. But anybody else up there, she was going to vote for, you know, the girl to win.
Did you have a path to victory to win in this jury vote? Do you feel like that you had a good shot to beat either of those other two people you were up against?
I do, and I just feel like...
Which one?
Paul or Nicole. Actually, it was more Paul, but Nicole...
Who were the votes that you had?
I felt like I would have had Michelle... Natalie, and Bridget, and I thought I was going to have Day, but Day was pretty mad at me.
She was mad at you.
She was so
That's
mad
still
at
four.
Me.
That's only four.
And I was going to say, like, whoever came down to Final Two, if they would have voted, like, Paul out or
something. Yeah, if Nicole would have voted out Paul, then he would have been pissed.
He would have been pissed, and I was hoping to get that vote, too.
Yeah.
But
who knows? It's hard to see.
It's hard to say.
How it's going to go. But do you feel so... you know, Paul. A lot of people have said Paul made the wrong mistake. He made the wrong move. If he would have taken you to the end,
he probably would have won.
Probably would have won, and you would have, and you would have been second.
Yeah, that. I haven't really talked to him about it. You know, but I feel like in the game, it doesn't matter what I would have said to him because Nicole was a really good social player, and she literally just did the honest card and said, "Hey, James is, you know, he's talking to me about votes," and like, and then Paul found out, took it the wrong way, and. You know, ultimately, he was like, that's it. I'm done with James. Like, it's me and you.
All right. Now, James, you were in another Final Three tonight. You were in the Final Three for America's Favorite Player. But then Victor ends up being America's Favorite Player. What changed in America since you've been gone?
You know, I honestly feel like my gameplay was very consistent with last season. I feel like the America wanted to see something
new
different.
Hotness? Is that
new
what
hotness.
They wanted?
I feel like they wanted me to come in guns blazing, like putting people up, beasting comps out. They like, I don't care, like kiss my butt because I'm putting you up on the block.
Yeah.
That's what they wanted to see. And plus, Victor, you know, we had to vote the kid out three times.
Yeah.
Man, if y'all would have told me I had to vote this kid out three times, I wouldn't have voted nobody out.
Yeah.
A pre-jury, I mean, it was nuts.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, the kid, mad props to him. He came back in the game three times.
Three times. So you're happy for Victor?
I'm happy for him as the outgoing.
Yes, America's Favorite Player.
AFP, I'm really happy for him.
Yeah. All right, so in terms of where you ultimately went wrong, like it felt like there was a point where you had a lot of momentum, that you had yourself, Natalie, Big Meech. It looked like that you had three and then there was only two other showmances.
That's what
ultimately,
went south.
Yeah. So what ultimately went wrong?
Well, what ultimately went wrong is Big Meech did not talk to Nicole and Corey.
Yeah.
And she just went off.
None of you guys really campaigned that week.
We didn't. But, like, with me and Natalie, I know I should have talked to Corey and Nicole about it, but, you know, I just felt like me and Natalie, I didn't want, and actually Big Meech don't even know this, but I kind of put a target on her back.
Uh-oh.
I told Nicole, you know, that, you know, Big Meech is actually coming for you. But I did that for Natalie because I didn't want Natalie to be in front of her.
Yeah.
I wanted Michelle to be in front of Natalie, if anything. So.
All right, James. Let's ask some hard questions now. Okay. So let's talk about. So what's going on with you and Natalie?
You know, I'm not really sure. You know, I'll be honest with you. This has been a tough.
I think you should have proposed tonight.
Who, me?
Yeah.
I don't want to.
Put her on the spot.
If I proposed her tonight, you see that big wall over there, she would jump over it. And she would run.
James, this is just like when Nicole and Corey were HOH. You got to go. You gotta get an answer.
That is true.
You can't be in limbo.
I can't be in a limbo.
You
got to
either move on. You got to either move on with your life or get a straight answer.
That's true.
Even if it's no, you have more clarity then.
That is true. Hopefully, like I said, after you know all this is settled, like I'm gonna find out. Hey, where are we staying at? She gave me good vibes when we got off the show. You know,
Whoa.
She was holding my hand.
Whoa.
You know, we were intertwining arms. So
yeah.
I mean, that's some good signs right there, man.
Yeah, you should have gone to the jury house. At least then you should have been. Like, if you weren't going to win the game, you should have just got voted out right there.
I'm telling
you. And then you could have just figured, like, oh, okay, this is nothing, or this is something. Now you're still in limbo.
If I had a crystal ball and I would have known the third place, I still would have done third place.
Talk to me about BBOTT. Are you happy about this BBOTT?
Yes, it's. I want to see who's the cast.
Yes, Jose is going to be on it. Maybe either Jose Jason? Or Jason. You played with both of them.
Jose is a character by himself.
Yeah.
You know, first day he was giving out chores.
Yes.
He was telling us to do dishes, and I'm like, man, bro, you know, pump the brakes, man.
Yeah.
Like, geez. He came in real guns hot, but Jason. I'm a big supporter of Jason. He's on my season. I would like to see the kid go far.
Yes. And so give us an endorsement.
What kind of endorsement?
Jason, so vote for Jason, you're saying.
Oh, yeah, vote for Jason. Definitely vote for Jason Roy. He's awesome. Season 17.
Okay.
He got cheated. Give a guy a chance.
Give him a break.
Give him
a break and not the Messiah.
And not the Messiah, yes.
not the Messiah of the newbies. James, do you feel like you have a third Big Brother run in next? What are you going to do next summer?
You know, I got to be honest with you. I really want to crack at Survivor.
Yeah.
Survivor? Yes.
I really want
to crack at it.
Yeah.
I'm really, man, if they was to make us sleep outside for 99 days, I would do that. Big Brother is my thing.
You should go on Australian Survivor. That's like 55 days.
I would do that.
Okay.
I would leave this yard right now, get on a van, and go.
Go. All right. You said tonight that you talked to a lot of the great players for advice. Talk to us about who talked to you.
All right. I talked to my boy, Derek. You know, you got to give him some street creds. You know, I said, you know what? Before I came on the show, I'm like, bro, I just really need some good advice, you know. And I took a little bit from Vanessa, what she told me when we were in the HOH room. Said, James, the reason why I've been targeting you all season is because you've been winning. You have a 33% chance of winning the comp.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, okay. So I took that into consideration. And then Derek told me the same thing. Like, bro, throw everything halfway through the game. He's like, your social game should carry you far.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, then if you got to, turn up at the end.
Okay. Who else?
Vanessa and Derek.
Vanessa and Derek, and that's it.
But those are two great players, though.
Okay, those are.
And
but Vanessa didn't mention to you that her sister was going to play.
She did not mention that. And this was actually the advice that I got when she was actually on the season.
Okay.
I didn't talk to her after the season, so that advice was just memorized in my head from season 17.
All right, James, what's next for you? Besides, you got to figure out. You got a to do list of. You got to figure out what's going on with Natalie.
Got to do. Yep. And after that, got to. Beg my boss back for my job.
Yes.
And I go on Rob Has a Podcast.
You're already here.
So.
You're already here. All right. Well, if you want to talk about BBOTT sometime, James.
Definitely give me a holler.
Talk about either Jason or Jose.
Jason or Jose.
Yeah. All right, James. Nice to meet you, buddy.
You too, Rob.
Take care.
You take care, buddy.
Bye. Hey, everybody. Rob Cicerino back here in the Big Brother backyard. And we've got El Fitvic.
Hey.
Victor is here, America's favorite house guest. Oh, people were campaigning so hard for you, Victor.
Really?
Yes. People wanted you to win. They said, vote Victor. It finally worked. And it's surprising because you never won one of the care packages.
No, to be honest, America, I was kind of sad that I didn't get a care package, but turns out I guess I didn't need it.
We don't know what happened.
Yeah, I don't know what happened either, but I really enjoyed it. I'm so happy that they voted me to get America's Favorite. I'm honored, and I wasn't playing for America's Favorite, but I'm happy that y'all saw that I guess, deserved it. So thank you.
Good job. We were really all pulling for you, or I guess I speak for everybody, but a lot of us were really pulling for you towards the end, especially the second time after you came back into the house. I really thought you had a chance. Do you feel like that maybe you and Paul might have been naive in terms of not seeing when Nicole and Corey were going to screw you guys over?
The thing is, you know, the people that saw my game, I played an honest and loyal game the whole time. I could have, in fact, put them up on the block and evicted them, but I would have did the same thing that I was preaching myself the whole season, be loyal.
Yeah.
So I didn't want to, it was already that far in the game, I didn't want to turn on what I stood for, and so I just went with it. And honestly, I thought they were going to take us to the Final Four, but I guess, like you said, it was very naive. Hindsight's always 20/20, and I don't regret anything.
Now, how big of a fan of Big Brother were you coming into the season?
I was a decent-sized fan. I can't say I was a super fan.
You're no Big Meech.
Yeah.
Not a super fan.
I'm no Big Meech like super fan, but I was a fan of the show.
Okay. A medium fan.
Okay,
Like when Corey said that Paul was a medium player.
Oh,
yes, a medium fan.
Eek.
So what went wrong for Paul? Because I think that, first off, we were surprised that he took Nicole to the end over James.
That was his only mistake, to be honest. That was his, because he had a choice.
Yeah.
So given if he didn't have a choice, then the conversation would be should he have said the things that he said that people thought were kind of offensive.
Did you know as soon as he took Nicole that he was going to lose?
No, I didn't. I thought it was a toss-up. I really thought if he took Nicole, it was going to be a 5-4. If he took James, it would have been a blowout.
Yeah, because I'm sure you were lobbying for him on the jury.
I was,
for
sure.
But it's hard now when you get to these individual matchups.
Exactly, exactly. And, I mean, I especially since he won all these competitions at the end, I thought that was going to be a credit to him. But I guess they saw the strategy behind Nicole's gameplay. And they gave it to her. My hat's off to her, too, because she played a heck of a game.
Yeah. Now, what are the chances you're getting voted into BBOTT?
BBOTT? I have no idea.
Yeah.
I really don't know. I'm just kidding.
Did you know what BBOTT is yet?
No, I have no idea.
Oh, Victor, that 1 week from tonight, a new season of Big Brother is starting. Yes, that all these twists. There was one twist. Yes. And did you know that Jose is eligible to be voted back into the...
Really?
Yes, Victor. I'm not messing with you.
I'm in fairy world over here. I don't know what's going on. I've been locked up for all this time. I have no idea what's going on.
It's so crazy. What is it like to be like not just like back out of the captivity with the Big Brother house, but just to be thrown into like this crazy scene?
I mean... It's the backyard. I've been here before many a times, but it's crazy
You've
to see
You've left and come back many times.
I've been out of this place 3 times, but it's nice. It's a refresher not having the game on your back anymore, not having to talk about strategy or win anything comp-wise. I mean, it feels good. It's over, and I'm happy just to share the time with everybody now.
But what a journey it's been for you from what were you voted out, like third?
I was voted out third, day 23.
And then to have the destiny of being America's favorite house guest at the end of it, like that's a really crazy journey.
I needed that journey, to be honest, because if I would have been voted out and just stayed out, I wouldn't have won America's Favorite. America had a seat.
And you beat James.
Exactly. People, past America's Favorite, he stayed in the whole time. And so, like,
old news.
People had to see the journey that I took.
New hotness.
The game, new hotness, the beard, the hair, I don't know.
Okay. Well, do you have an appetite to come back and play again in another season? Maybe not OTT.
I would, a regular season. I mean, I would love it. I mean, this was an experience of a lifetime. I wouldn't change it for the world, and I would do it again if I was given the chance.
All right. Well, Elfitvik, did it piss you off when Paul said he won more in-house competitions than you? Did that piss you off? A little
he
bit, right?
He needed to say that for his fight to win the 500K. But, yeah, technically in-house comps, he did win more, but
you
should have
counted when you won the TV with Ziggy Marley.
That's another comp win.
Yes.
That is true,
All right. Well, Victor, so nice to meet you.
Nice to meet
All
you,
All the
too.
Best to you. Okay,
thank
Take
you
care,
so
buddy.
Much.
Bye. Hey, everybody, Rob here with Corey in the backyard.
Corey,
holy crap!
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
Can't believe it.
You're like the first husband of Big Brother now.
The first husband, huh?
Yeah.
Is that what they're calling me? All right. I mean, I'll take it.
I don't know if it's called you that yet. I'll start it.
My girl Nicole came through. Yeah.
Yes, boy. Now that's really gotta up those relationship prospects, right?
Oh my gosh!
Right. If you're on the fence about like all of a sudden, it's
exactly.
like boy, you should propose tonight.
I should. You know, never know. Not as young.
You should. Oh, okay. So how were you surprised at all with this outcome, or did you know right from when Paul took Nicole to the end that it was going to be she got this?
Because
in the room, we were sitting there like, oh, I think he should have taken James.
Right. I agree. If he wanted to win 500,000, he should have taken James, in my opinion. When I saw her up there, I couldn't believe it. I was like, this is her chance, and honestly, I think she has it in the bag.
Yeah. Would you have voted for James over Paul? Because with his vote, ultimately at the Final Four, got you out.
Right. No, I think I would have voted for Paul to win. Paul played a very good game, and, you know, the fact that it was Paul versus Nicole at the end, just, you know, that was awesome. So, no, I think that it was Paul versus James. I think Paul would have won.
Yeah. How much were you and Nicole on the same page throughout the game? What was, like, the biggest game decision that you guys disagreed about?
Disagreed?
Yeah.
Shoot, man. Well, honestly, we played devil's advocate quite a bit, you know, just throwing ideas off each other. But we never really disagreed about anything. I mean, everything that we did, we kind of made a team decision on it.
Yeah.
And she played an equal part in everything as well as I did. So, no, we were pretty much – we hit on all cylinders.
I think that one of the best things that you brought to the table was that where a lot of people, like, would get, like, panicky and freak out, you never lost your cool.
No,
you were very even-keeled no matter what. Oh, like, Corey, you need to sit on the block. All right, sure, whatever.
Yeah.
You never got, like, you know, went crazy.
Right. No, I stayed very calm and collected. I handle pressure very well.
Yeah.
You know, I've been in it many times. And so, you know, I just know that, hey, if I'm going to be put up, I got to prove myself, win a veto or, you know, do what I got to do to stay in this game.
Yeah. So in terms of now, it's going to the end of the game. I thought you were in a really good spot in the final five.
Yeah.
Because all of a sudden you started winning competitions and you were coming through. And then we started hearing about Snake Call. And I felt like if you guys got to the final two, do you feel like you would have beaten Nicole?
Yeah, I think I would have had her.
Oh!
Honestly, I think I might have had her. Sorry, Nicole.
Let's go!
Let's go.
Did I say it right?
Let's go.
Yeah. I think that would have been really interesting
if we would have
got there. And I'm not sure it would have been the first woman beating a man in the end.
Yeah, well, she deserves it ultimately. You know, she got there. She put in the work. So
how much did you lobby in the jury house to make the case? Because you were with Dr. Will.
Yeah.
You said, I believe the quote was, you said, Paul, I think he was like a medium player, right?
I don't remember saying that. But, no, I think Paul's a good player. It's just that there was some there was some discussion saying he had a lot of influence, manipulator, and I was like, wait a second, who did he manipulate?
Yeah.
Like, what did he do exactly? Like, I mean, he didn't even control his own HOH, you know? So I was like, you know, where are these facts coming from? So that's what I was probably saying in that context.
How excited are you that Christmas Corey has really become a thing?
I mean, I'm excited for it. I love Christmas time. But my birthday is actually on Halloween, so I'm pretty pumped for
that. Are you a big Halloween guy also?
Yeah, it's my favorite holiday. You know, I was born on it, so it's hard to compete against that.
Yeah. All right, so in terms of you and Nicole, was there any sort of mistrust between you and Nicole? Like, are you thinking at all that she might have been thinking, oh, I can bring Corey to the end, he'll be a goat? Or did you feel like that's just like she'd be playing with fire if she did something like that?
No, I mean, I definitely think that Nicole would have taken him to the end. She was very loyal. You know, we had each other's back, so there's no doubt in my mind that we would have been up there
now,
next to each other.
In a week, it's going to be BBOTT. Are you pumped up for that? Have you heard about what the... Corey.
Yeah, I just heard about it a second ago.
So they're going to do another Big Brother season 1 week from tonight.
Nuh-uh.
Yes.
Oh, gosh.
Why would I make that up, Corey?
I don't know, man.
Yeah.
I don't know. That's pretty crazy.
It's going to be coming up 1 week from tonight, and Jose might be on it. The Messiah.
Oh, Jose?
Yes.
Oh, he's probably going to write a book on how he's going to win that one, too, huh?
Yes. Yes. And he started it. He started that Nicole is a snake.
Oh,
and that really caught on.
Yeah.
And now he could be on the Messiah. The prophecy of the Messiah returning could be coming true, Corey.
Oh, my gosh. Here we go.
Yeah.
That'll be a good one to watch for sure.
Yeah. How much Big Brother had you seen before you came into the game?
Yeah, I've watched it on and off. You know, I'm a baseball coach. I've been in baseball. It's always on nights that I'm in practice or in games. But, you know, last year, Clay, he played football at A&M. I watched, you know, most of his season. 16, I watched a lot of that one. I watched, you know, on and off a couple seasons previous before that, too. So.
Yeah. How hard was it for you and Nicole to ultimately turn on Victor and Paul when you guys got down to the final five? Because it seemed like that you were the one driving the bus more than that on Nicole. Of like, hey, let's do it. We're not playing big baby.
Yeah, no, she had my back too. Like, it was we'd be crazy to not make that move. I mean, it was very easy. I mean, Vic stabbed us in the back after the double eviction. He lied to us, put me and Paulie up. So, you know, I had to do what I had to do. So, but it was a good game move in the end.
Okay. Now, in terms of you and Nicole, but real talk now, Corey.
Yeah.
So what's the next? You're gonna like, oh, let's play it by ear.
Yeah.
Is this like a James and Natalie thing?
No, honestly, you know, I have strong feelings for Nicole. She means a lot. We were honestly like this the entire game. Like she said, since day one, within 2 hours of being in the house, like instant connection. And so I definitely want to, you know, continue and see if it progresses. She lives in Michigan, but we'll see where it goes.
I want to ask you about, there was a point when you were the HOH and you had to decide who you were going to put up on the block, and there was, we saw on the show, you went really like insane about cleaning the house. You said the house is a mess.
You sure that wasn't Vic?
No, it was you. It was, I remember. And you were just cleaning everything. Is that something that you do
when I was HOH?
Yes.
Huh. I don't remember that. I'm a clean freak.
What about Harry Potter dreams, Harry Potter games.
Yeah, you know what? I just heard about that from Jeff. I have no idea, you know, what happened. Supposedly I was.
What did he say about Harry Potter?
He said that I was screaming or talking about Harry Potter in my sleep.
He loves Harry Potter.
Yeah, well, I like Harry Potter, but
yes.
I don't know how that was put into my dreams.
I don't know.
Yeah,
Inception.
Inception, right?
Okay. All right. Well, Corey, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too,
All
Rob,
the best
sure.
to you and Nicole.
Yeah, absolutely.
And,
thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks so much for coming on.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Hey, everybody. We are here with Big Meech is here on the podcast. And Michelle, how are you doing? So many people were rooting for you because you were the super fan.
Yes. I love how you say because.
Yes.
So I
good, always listen to your podcast. Good. All right. So how are you doing, Michelle?
I'm sad that I didn't
You're always sad.
I am a super fan, so it was such a fun time being there. Dream come true. I'm on Rob Has a Podcast.
That was the dream?
I'm missing Jordan, though.
Jordan.
Big fan of Jordan Parhar.
Yeah. Well, he's live right now.
Really?
Doing, yeah.
Hey, Jordan.
Somebody else had to be here. What about Ian?
Ian. Oh, I am excited to meet that kid.
Yes.
I hope so.
Yes. Okay, good. All right. Let's talk about the game, because this was the worst case scenario for you, where Nicole ultimately wins the game. Snake Hall ends up winning the game.
Did
what
you
happened?
Guys see my pictures?
Yeah, so the snake with half Nicole.
You know, at the end of the day, she did play a good game, but I felt like Paul played a better game, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But what can you do? It is what it is.
What can you do? Why do you feel like Nicole played? Because you were really down on Nicole from what we saw with Dr. Will. You were like the one dissenting opinion in the room. Nicole, she didn't do anything.
What
make the case against Nicole? Why should she? Is she an unrightful winner?
No, I don't think she's an unrightful winner.
I don't know if that's a word either, to be honest.
She definitely deserves to be there, but my question to her and the jury was, what was your biggest move? And she said convincing Natalie.
Yeah.
But all she really did was just tell her something about Paul coming after James. That's all she told. She didn't do anything else.
Yeah.
And she didn't manipulate me either. It was my decision. I knew I wouldn't have the votes to get her out anyways.
I'll tell you where I felt like you got really screwed over. I felt like when you won the care package. I felt like that was a bad thing for you to be co-HOH that week.
Mm-hmm.
It knocked you out of playing HOH in the next week. I felt like, and it wasn't the end, you got co-HOH.
Mm-hmm.
What was that? So I felt like that screwed you over, I felt.
Maybe America hates me. I don't know.
No. Well, probably some people, but not everybody.
Yeah.
Not everybody. So, but I felt like you were in a really good spot coming out of where Paulie got voted out.
Mm-hmm.
I felt like you had a lot of meachmentum at that point in the game.
I was solid. I mean, I had Victor and Paul on my side, and I had Natalie and James on my side. All I had to do was get out Corey and Nicole.
Yeah. You were very vocal about you felt like that James would have been a deserving winner for the game. Why did you feel like that James would have been good to win?
Well, I think that James was only on the block once, same as Nicole, I know. But I think he played a very, just a great game. He didn't really do a lot of lying. He didn't do a lot of, like, breaking people's, like, promises, stuff like that. And he didn't need a whole bunch of guys protecting him. He protected Natalie. He did the protecting, which I think is amazing.
We saw a really crazy fight that happened in the jury house between Davon and Paulie. And when it looked like that Paulie was going to hit Davon, and they were, like, got in each other's face, and Davon is like, is this who you lay with? And it got really crazy. I mean, how heated was that in real life?
Well, as a super fan, it was first row tickets to one hell of a show.
Yeah.
So I was, you know, enjoying it in the moment. But at the end of the day, I don't think he should have brought her child into it. And
yeah.
I think that Davon needed to stand up for herself.
Did things calm down after that, or was it just really tense the whole way through?
It felt like we were still in the Big Brother house. The house was clearly still divided.
Mm-hmm.
During round table went more smoothly than I thought it would go.
Yeah, but you got so upset. It seemed like it went very quickly into that you were almost in tears. Did Dr. Will harass you?
When am I not in tears?
Yeah, but you seemed like you were very upset.
Yeah, Dr. Will was definitely more intense and hurtful in person, but I know that's just his
Now, he
persona.
Was, it looked like that he was in the middle and you were at the chair so far away from him. Did he want you as far away from him as possible? Did he set that up that way?
Maybe, who knows?
Yeah.
Now that I think about it.
Meet Chelsea, why did you tell everybody that you were Dan Giesling's cousin-in-law?
Okay, I wanted to screw with Nicole's head because I know she's a big fan of Dan.
Yes.
So I wanted her to feel some kind of regret for evicting me and
Dan said you are not his cousin-in-law.
Was he insulted?
I don't think he was insulted.
Okay.
Yeah, but he said no, that was not the case. You know, we had the whole Big Meech speech all the time, but you didn't really, blast anybody on finale night.
No, I mean, there's nothing much I can do. I can't affect anyone's votes, and there's nothing really much to say, but congrats. They made it to Final 2. I didn't.
Yeah. Tell me, are you going to be, as a super fan, Big Meech, are you going to be following BBOTT?
I am so excited. I don't know what it is. Can you fill me in more?
BBOTT. Well, I want, if you go to the website, you can sign up on CBS All Access.
Oh, hell yeah.
There's a season of Big Brother that's starting 1 week from tonight, Big Meech.
Oh, my God. I am so excited.
Yes. Oh, good. Because I think we were wondering if you guys were going to be pissed.
Can I be on the commentary one
yes,
time?
Yes, yes. We'll do a podcast. We'll do a podcast to talk about BBOTT. And it's only going to be on the internet. It's only going to be on CBS All Access.
All starts right, one cool. week from tonight. I don't have to set my DVR.
Yes. And so it'll be fun.
The future of TV.
10 weeks. Just 10 weeks.
Oh, really?
Only 250K. America's going to pick
the
winner. Well, do you know about Jose being up for...
I'm so excited.
Yes.
I'm so excited.
Give the pitch to people. Why should Jose be voted in?
I think Jose should be voted in because he is hilarious. He will bring entertainment. As a super fan watching this season, I would have rooted for Jose because he's hilarious. And, you know, he speaks his mind just like me. So I think he'll make one hell of a player.
All right, Michelle. Well, so fun to get to meet you in real life. Real quick, I know everyone wants to know... who's your favorite of the live feed correspondents?
Jordan.
Well, he's not really. Of Taryn, Brennan, and Alex.
Taryn, Brennan, and I don't know.
You don't like any of them?
No, I just don't know them that well.
Okay.
I love Jordan. I'm sorry.
Jordan. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Even though his gameplay, but.
So, okay. Shots fired. All right. Big Meech, thank you so much. I do hope that we can do some podcasting for when we get to BBOTT.
Yes. You look
Should
different
be a lot
in
of fun.
Person. I didn't recognize
Better
you.
Better or worse? Worse?
No, really good.
Oh, really? Really, really good.
Right? I thought you were older.
Not that old. Gen Xer, not a millennial.
Gotcha.
That's the Survivor season.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember hearing your podcast on Dan's. Podcast, How to Get on Reality TV.
Yeah, yeah. Is that how you got on? You followed Dan's advice?
I was on
Your
there.
Cousin-in-law?
My question's on there.
Yeah,
you
okay.
can go see it.
All right, well, we're going to check. When are you going to get back to Reddit?
Tonight.
Tonight, yes. Wow.
I
All
might
right.
do an AMA. We'll
AMA.
See.
Ask Meech anything.
Yes!
Yes, yes that's the hashtag.
Great.
All right, thank you so much, Michelle, and great to
Pleasure.
Meet you in person.
I'm so excited. Come here, you. I'm so happy to meet you.
Very nice to meet you, and take care. I'll see you soon.
Give Jordan my regards.
Okay.
BB Canada, love it. Because guess what? After after this BB over whatever, over the top,
yes.
then we have Big Brother Canada. Yes.
Big Brother is a 365-day-a-year sport.
I love it.
Yeah, all right. Big Meech is happy. She's the winner. She didn't win the game, but she's got a lot of Big Brother to watch.
Yes.
All right, we are here in the backyard with Natalie. Natalie, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Yes, very good. First off, how upset are you that James did not end up being the winner tonight?
I'm really bummed. It's a very heartbreaking experience. I really wanted him to win, but you know what? I'm proud of him. He made Final 3. That's
yes.
amazing.
So that did you feel like he was going to win that Final HOH? Did you feel like he had a good shot at all?
I mean, of course.
I didn't think he had a good shot.
I always hope for him.
I thought maybe somebody would bring him, but I didn't think he had a good shot to win the final
Yeah, I was
three.
Hoping someone would bring him.
Someone bring
sure.
And then do you think that if anybody brought him to the end, he might have won?
I do think so. I mean, he had a pretty good rapport.
Who do you have a better chance with? Against James or, I'm sorry, against Paul or against Nicole?
Maybe Nicole.
Nicole.
I don't know, honestly.
Yeah.
Maybe Paul. I don't know.
Yeah.
That's a hard one.
Boy, did Paul blow it by taking Nicole to the end instead of
yes,
James?
Yes, 100% Paul blew it for taking Nicole.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man. And you voted for Nicole.
Nicole.
You and James did not vote the same.
Yeah, we did
Why
not.
Why James over Paul?
I mean, me and James never vote that. We didn't always vote the same.
Yes.
But I picked Nicole over Paul because, I mean, Nicole is a woman, and I really wanted a woman to win this season,
yes.
and I feel like she played such a good game. She didn't hit the block except one time.
Yes.
Paul was managing to get himself on the block all the time, repeatedly. And
but not
I
get
feel,
voted out.
Yeah, but not get voted out. But Nicole just played a cleaner game,
yeah.
and I respect her game, and I voted for her. I honestly loved her game.
So in terms of the Nicole vote, you had said to James when he was still in the house, if you work with Nicole and Corey, then I'll never talk to you again.
Yeah.
You took it back. You took
I
it
did.
Back. But it seemed like that you, so you don't like, you didn't love them.
I mean, it's a game, and I was never aligned with them.
Yeah.
So just knowing that they backstabbed me, I was a little butthurt.
Yes.
And I said things. You say things out of the heat of the moment. But I did take it back because I wanted James to do what was best for his game, whether it's working with Corey or Nicole or Victor and Paul, whatever he needed to do to get to Final 2, that's what I wanted him to do.
Now, you campaigned pretty hard against Paul at the point where that Nicole brought up when it was down to 5-2,
mm-hmm.
That you said that that Paul was, he made comments.
Yeah.
And was any of that still, for you, a factor in why you didn't want him to win?
100%. I made my choice both personal and game-wise.
Yes.
I respected Nicole's game, and I do respect Paul's game as well, but I think Nicole played a better game. And personally, honestly, Paul, you know, said a lot of things that were a little hurtful. And, you know, why am I going to give someone $500,000 that didn't treat me very well?
Okay. All right. Let's start to get into some tough questions now, Natalie. All right. This Friday night, MacGyver is on. You'll be sitting. I know you can't wait. You're very excited to watch MacGyver. It looks so good, right?
Yes, I can't wait to watch TV.
So will you be sitting there with James watching MacGyver all season long?
Did you ask James this question
yet? I haven't talked to him yet.
Oh,
I know what he's going to say. I know what he's going to say.
Honestly.
The question, as far as I'm concerned, in terms of like when you like launch this nuclear missile and then both people have to turn their key, I think he's turning his key. For you, you're the one, I don't know if you're ever turning the key. That's my question for you.
Well, I'm a realist, and, you know,
I don't think you give a straight answer to this question.
Yeah, I'm not going to give a straight answer to this one. You know, I'm really good with my words.
James gives an answer, like, straight as an arrow.
He's a straight shooter.
Yes.
I'm more of, you know, I like to keep people guessing.
Oh, yeah, I think you're keeping him guessing. I think you that I have a guess. I have a guess. But I think you keep him guessing.
Uh-huh.
I don't know. Is this really going to work out?
Honestly, I don't know James outside the house.
I feel like you guys are just friends.
You think that?
Yes.
What makes you think that?
I feel like that I think that if there was like the chemistry was so hot, I feel like that that it's like magnetism. You can't stay away from each other, even if you wanted to.
I mean, I was really excited to see him tonight, and I do have strong feelings for him.
Yes.
But at the end of the day, he lives in Texas, and I live in New Jersey, New York. So, I mean, I got to see what happens.
Okay.
We are very far away.
Yes. Are you pumped up to watch Jets football this
year? Yes, of course.
Do you know how the Jets are doing?
I have no idea how the Jets are doing.
1-1. 1-1.
Right, really? Yes. Woo!
They beat Buffalo on Thursday.
J-E-T-S, Jets.
Yes. So can you talk about your relationship in the jury house with we saw definitely some fighting going on in the jury house. How are things with you and Paulie in the jury house?
Honestly, I'm pretty calm, cool, and collected. I was very kind in the jury house.
And you feel like that was not reciprocated?
No, I do. I do. You know, we're calm. We're in the jury house. It's like a game, and we're out of the game now, you know. It is what it is.
Yeah. All right. So BBOTT is coming up next week.
Uh-huh. I'm excited. Is Jose really on the show?
Well, he's not really on the show yet. He is on the ballot to go back into the show.
Oh, my God.
He has a 50-50 chance to go back into the house. Do you want to see the Messiah return to this backyard 1 week from tonight?
Oh, heck yes. I better see Jose. Literally there. I mean, I'm going to be his number one fan. I think he's the most entertaining human in the whole entire world.
Yes.
And I'll be rooting for him if he gets on.
Wow. Okay, so that's good. So you are pro...
He's hilarious. Come on.
You're pro Jose.
Yes, of course.
For you and James, where do you guys feel like things really went wrong? Like, what was the point where felt like that you guys were in a really good spot, especially around that final 7 point? Was it targeting Paul and Victor, or you stand by that was still a good move at that point?
Honestly, I feel like my downfall in my game was not putting Corey and Nicole up on the block when I was HOH.
Yeah.
I was trying to protect James, and...
Now, Nicole talked about that in her speech tonight, that she manipulated you. Mm-hmm. She got you to put up your allies at the point. Do you feel like you agree with that statement, that she did sort of like push you in that direction?
I definitely agree with it. It's like a 50-50 for me. I feel like, yeah, she got me to trust her, and I thought we were working together for a goal to get Paul and Victor out.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, I was trying to protect James, and I thought that Paul was coming after James. So that's why he was my target.
Yeah. You know what else wasn't great? When James said in front, like really loud, that you were trying to get him to vote out Nicole and Corey, or vote out Corey when he was on the block, and then Corey, they like heard that. That wasn't good.
Oh,
yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Was I there?
Yeah. I don't remember who was where. But that wasn't great. That wasn't great either.
Oh, that's not cool. That's not cool.
But now, you seem like such a fun, nice person.
Thank you.
All the best to you.
Thank
outside.
You.
What do you like besides figuring out what you and James are outside of the house? What are you gonna do following Big Brother?
I'm so excited to see my family. I love you guys. That is literally the one thing I want to do, see my family and my friends. That is my number one priority.
Number one priority. All right.
Yes.
So nice to meet you, Natalie.
Nice
all
to meet
the best
you.
To
Thanks
you.
Thanks for having me.
And let's go Jets.
Yeah. Yes. Let's go Jets.
Hey, everybody, we're here with Davon. Davon, I can't believe it. You were like the deciding vote in this finale. And you voted for Nicole and not your boy. And I was counting the votes. It's like this election. And I'm trying to like go through all the states. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, okay, well, Davon is definitely, you said, oh, it better not be Paul.
Yeah.
I don't want Paul to get voted out here. Ugh. But then you didn't vote for him.
I know. Because I thought it was going to be Paul and James. And I was going to
You don't
give
even like
Paul,
Nicole.
100%. I don't. But I didn't want to vote bitter. I didn't want to vote bitter. I wanted to vote better. And she played a great game from on the inside. I don't know what the outside looked like, but from the inside, she played a good game.
Okay. I can't get over it. I can't believe it. I mean, it's fine.
Yeah.
It's fine. I was rooting for Paul to ultimately win the game. So a little bit pissed. Did you have hard feelings with Paul? Because I know that there was a lot of stuff that went on. The week that you went out, it was on Paul's HOH.
Yeah.
And it was really, Paulie was really the one, pulling the strings. And Paul ultimately gave in and let Paulie have what he wanted that week. Were you mad at Paul after all that? I'm sure that came out in the jury house.
Yes, I was. I knew in the house.
Yeah.
When Paul asked me, you know, I need somebody that I can trust. I was like, you about to get me evicted out of this house. I knew in that moment.
Yes.
And I was disappointed in him, and going the whole week watching him lie to me, that was difficult too. But I forgave him. I felt like she deserved it.
Yeah. Tell me about this fight in the jury house, Davon, because we got to see where, you know, Paulie really got in your face about everything, and you were in his face.
Yeah.
I mean, how real was all of that?
That was very real. I don't anticipate on being friends with Paulisha after the show. I don't think that we should be friends.
Yeah.
I have nothing else to say to him. He brought my child into it. That's what you don't do. You can say whatever you want to say about me. I got thick skin. I can handle it. But you don't bring my child into it. That's where he messed up.
See, it seemed to me like, okay, that everything was going good.
Yeah.
You were there with Bridget and Zakiya, everybody's good, and you watch the video, it's like, oh my God, Paulie, what an idiot, and he got voted out, and then Zakiya was telling him that, you know, you're a loser, and you're whatever, but then all of a sudden they got back together. How did that happen?
He sweet-talked her right back in.
Yeah.
He got some words. I wasn't buying nothing he was selling.
Davon, what's going to happen with them after the show?
I think they're going to stay together. They really like each other.
They're going to stay together?
I think they really like each other.
Oh, this is like breaking news.
I think they really like each other.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Well, you got to tell us that we have this BBOTT. Are you? Have you been updated on all this?
Oh, Team Jason.
Yeah, you're down with OTT.
Yes.
You know me.
Yes, I know you. So, all right. So give us the pitch. Why should people? Because you had somebody from your original team, Jose, the Messiah of the newbies.
I know.
Going up against Jason in this fan vote.
I know.
Why should people vote for Jason over the Messiah?
People should vote for Jason because Jason is a super fan. Jason loves this game. Jason eats, sleeps, and breathes Big Brother, every country version of the show. He knows this game, and he deserves another chance. I feel like he got cheated, and I feel like it was partially my fault last year. So I believe he deserves another chance.
Yeah, I like Jason. I feel like Jose created so much drama, though.
Yeah, he's drama.
He's drama.
He's drama. But you want a game player, or you want drama?
Yeah, that's true.
See?
It's true. I could see. Look, it's going to be – it's a win-win.
Yeah.
It's a win-win.
Yeah.
So then tell us about your relationship with James, because it was hard to really get a read whether or not you would have voted for him or not if he got to the end. It seemed like you guys were close in the house.
Yeah.
But was there a falling out?
Well, James – betrayed me. That was the one person in the house that I really, really trusted. And he was throwing me under the bus left and right, right to left. So I was just like, okay, James, it is what it is. And I let him go. Let's go.
Yeah.
And I was like, whatever, whatever. So that's what happened with me and him. But we'll be great afterwards. You know, whatever happened in the house happened in the house.
It seemed to me in watching the season, there was like two halves of the season. There was one half where it was like you versus Frank versus Tiffany.
Yeah.
That and everybody's going after everybody. And then all three of you guys are gone.
Yeah.
And then there was a whole second half of the season that ended up playing out. Do you have regrets about how hard you went after those targets in the first half of the game?
Yes, I do. Because I feel like the house wanted them out anyway, so all I had to really do was shut up and let them vote them out. That's really all I had to do was be quiet and be a vote. But I wanted to play.
Tell me, how close were you to getting on Survivor? I've heard you on the live feeds talk about, like, you know, I was going to be on Survivor.
I was there.
Tonight was the Survivor premiere, Millennials versus Gen X. Are you a millennial?
That's why I didn't give up.
Yes. Yeah.
They changed the theme at the last minute.
Yes.
And they were like, you don't fit the theme. And I was like, oh, okay. So I've been itching to know what the theme was.
Yes. Millennials versus Gen X.
Oh, gosh.
Yes.
Oh, gosh.
Yes.
This season is about to be all over the place.
Yeah. So... then, in terms of Big Brother, would you play a third time?
Oh, God. Call me in a couple years. This was intense. Couple years.
Well, Davon, I do hope that we could get your opinions on the BBOTT, especially if Jason is going to play.
Of course.
Even if Jose is going
to
play.
Yeah, I still watch.
We'd love to hear what you have to say. You were very fun, and those jury segments were wild.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Davon. It's so nice to meet you.
You as well. Thank you so much.
All right. Take care.
Okay.
Bye. All right, everybody, we are here with Paulie Calafiore. How are you?
What is up, man?
Am I saying that right?
Calafiore.
Calafiore, yes.
Roll that R.
Yes. Have you had a chance to see my brother Cody yet?
I have had a chance to see him. I didn't get to talk to him much. They just freaking grabbed me, and and that was that. But I got to give him a hug.
Okay, so I want to ask a Cody question. So obviously in his season, it was so much talk after the season about that final two. What about Paul and the decision that he made in the final two? Do you look at that similar as like a Derek and Victoria?
Similar in the sense that you got to bring the floater, but different because Derek was Cody's ride or die.
Yes.
You know?
So it's different.
And that's it.
Yeah. All right. So if Paul ends up bringing James to the end, who do you vote for?
I'd vote for Paul.
Vote for Paul.
That's it, man.
Okay. Was it close? Was it a toss-up for you, or was it Nicole all the way?
For me, it was a toss-up, man. I was flip-flopping this in my head like the entire time. I was still, weighing the options while I was there. The answer to the questions, the speeches, everything. I just put it all in my head, and then as I was walking up there, I was like, all right, here we go.
Yeah.
That's
you know, there was a point in this game when it looked like you just had when the fallout of Frank, Davon, Tiffany, they were all gone, it looked like you were just going to run the table. And what ultimately went wrong, in your opinion?
You know, what went wrong is two of my closest alliance members turned their backs on me. You know, it was definitely like a Brutus and Caesar moment.
Now, Paul and Victor, or is James in there also?
James.
Okay, James and who?
James and Paul.
James and Paul.
100%.
Okay. Not Victor?
No, I mean, Victor was loyal to it, but I knew that the only person that would have told Victor to put me up would have been Paul.
Yeah.
And that's the only person that Victor would have listened to other than me.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So we saw so much drama in the jury house.
Yeah.
Paulie.
Did you?
It got really crazy.
It got cray, man.
It got crazy.
It did.
It was a lot of bad stuff. Okay. First of all, let's just talk through this. So you and Zakiya. That's a thing now?
That's official, man. We're taking it step by step.
Step by step.
We're going to see each other.
Yes.
You can't make something official until you get to see each other outside of the house. But we want to see each other, and we're going to make it work as best we can.
So what was it like day-to-day in the jury house where it was it like the women in the jury house were pressuring her? Why are you still with Paulie?
100%.
Yeah.
They were 100% pressuring her because they didn't think I was coming through those doors, and they wanted to sway the jury to vote against me.
Yes.
They were still playing the game inside the jury house.
Yeah.
They were not able to separate game from reality.
And from what they told you, what was the reason why? Was it because they felt like that you didn't use the veto on Zakiya? What was the reason?
It was all game-related
reasons.
And for me, leave the game in the game. Take the personal stuff outside of the house.
We saw this very heated confrontation that you got into with Davon.
Yeah.
You guys really got into it.
Did we? I didn't think it was that bad.
It was bad. It was pretty bad.
I
thought it was pretty bad. And you guys really got into it in terms of it looked like almost like you guys were gonna like fist fight. It got very close. What was that like after that?
It was the same way that it was before that. They were not talking to me or Zakiya because Zakiya wanted to talk to me. They were making Zakiya feel like crap the entire time, which is why that whole blow-up even happened.
Yeah.
But in moments like that, the only thing you can do is show your class and keep yourself calm.
Yeah. So talk to me about with Paul and Victor ultimately going down to almost getting to the end. Were you rooting for that pair to get to the end or rooting against them?
Look, I'm not going to say I was rooting for or against certain people. Corey was my ride or die, so I wanted to see him go as far as possible. You got to root for Victor because he came back in the house twice. You know what I mean? He got evicted three times. He made history.
What would happen to Nicole if you ultimately, we saw that the executives and the guys were all sticking together. So what would happen to Nicole? Because we talked about, was Nicole playing the Christine game from BB16? Was she going to be the person who goes out at six?
She was not. She was not going out at six.
Yeah.
Corey and I had something with her. We had to play up the part that we were willing to sacrifice our ladies to the other guys who were sitting there worrying about the showmances.
So you would have eventually gone and segued to the two showmances in the final four?
So eventually what would have happened is you got to play week by week.
Yeah.
That's what the game of Big Brother is. You can't go back and say what would have happened.
Mm-hmm.
You can only say what did happen and what would have happened if you were still in the game. So who knows what would have happened? I don't know if it would have been a good time to take a shot at Vic, take a shot at Paul. I know that the plan was to take a shot at Victor after he won the second HOH. So we were going to let him win the HOH,
yeah,
put somebody up, let him evict him. He couldn't compete. Send him home.
Yeah. How confident were you heading into the battle back? Or whatever they – I don't think they really had a name for what it was that you were going to stand on the wall.
You know, I was really confident going back into the battle back. I mean, things happen. I'm a competitor, you know. But, hey, sometimes even the best competitors lose, and that's exactly what happened.
So – who from this cast is it still awkward with you, or do you feel like you're back on good terms with everybody?
Look, I'm not an awkward person. I don't need to talk to people that don't want
to. I don't know what it's like to not be awkward with anybody.
I'm not awkward. You know, put me in the middle of Times Square with a microphone and nothing on, and I still won't be awkward.
Whoa.
And that's it. Hey.
Like the naked cowboy?
Like the literal naked Jersey boy, something like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, for me, it's just like if people want to make it awkward, that's their prerogative.
Yeah.
I don't let negative energy run my life. I stay positive and I move forward.
All right. So with you and Zakiya, was the connection where that you felt like that she is unlike these typical Jersey girls from back home? Is it that she's so different from the Jersey women?
You know, let's not take it about Jersey women.
Yes.
I said that in the house
because
I was trying to separate James and Natalie from being as close as they were. Jersey girls, I grew up with them my whole life. Yes, everywhere you're going to run into certain types of women the same way you're going to run into certain types of men.
Yes.
But that has nothing to do with why I like her. I like her because she has a kind heart, and I like her because she's a good person.
Do you have a prediction on the James and Natalie thing?
I think it's pretty obvious.
Yes.
So, I mean, hey.
Yeah.
I think James will be old news in 2 weeks.
Old news? Oh, my God. Look, he's still top three of America's favorite player.
He is.
He's still right there.
Hey, that doesn't mean that his relationship
Are you sad that you missed out on any wing-eating contests at the Jersey Shore this summer?
You know, I was never much of a wing-eating contest guy, you know. That definitely doesn't fit well with trying to
Too much like Uncle Austin's trailer.
You know, I don't even know if it'll be like that. It's more like puking in a toilet bowl after you have one of those wing competitions.
All right, so boy, what's next for you after Big Brother? You're going to watch BBOTT?
You know, I'm going to go home. I'm going to focus on my businesses, and I'm going to look to move my businesses to another place. I'm going to keep them on the East Coast. Maybe I'll open some up on the West Coast.
Hold on. So is this a hint that you're going to be moving them near a Zakiya location?
You know, hey, it could be anywhere. I got to check the demographic. I'm a businessman.
Okay.
I like to make money.
You just feel like that you need to move. You need to move your business.
No, I don't need to move my business.
You want to.
My businesses there.
Yes.
A good businessman likes to open up.
Oh, you
want to
diversify and be in more locations.
More locations.
Okay.
Franchise.
All right, Paulie. Thank you so much. Nice to meet you.
No problem, man.
All the best to you outside
of. Are you actually Rob?
I'm Rob.
You never said I'm Rob.
Yeah.
You just said we have Paulie.
That's true. I'm Rob. And this is Rob Has a Podcast.
Rob Has a Podcast. I love it.
All right.
Well, hey, man, pleasure speaking to you.
Nice talking to you, Paulie.
All right, brother.
Take care.
Have a good one.
Oh, I see you. Oh. Awkward, I see. All right, everybody. We are here in the backyard with Frank Udy. Frank, how are you?
Good. How you doing, Rob?
Very good, Frank. I'd love to get your take on this final two.
Absolutely.
In terms of who do you think should have won. Nicole was somebody you worked with very close.
Yep.
With your time in the house. Is she the rightful winner?
I think so. She's actually the person I've wanted to win, especially out of the last few people left in the house. I think, you know, some people say she floated, but the truth is I think she just was really good at staying under the radar, you know. She made alliances with the right people that trusted her and then weren't going to turn their back on her. And, you know, she stayed out of all the drama. And she still won competitions when she needed to. So, I mean, I think she did what she got to do. It's not easy to make it to the end of the game. And I think she did that. And she did it without getting in the drama, which keeps anybody from disliking her, hopefully.
What did you think of Paul's decision to take Nicole to the end instead of James?
It was not very smart.
Not good.
I think he would have crushed James, and he would have been $500,000 richer.
What is that? Did he get overconfident, or did he just have a bad read of what the jury thought of Nicole?
I'm not really sure. Some people have told me that he thought he was doing the right thing bringing her, even though he knew he could beat James. But if you know you can beat him, take him, you know? It's the only other reason I would take somebody that could maybe beat me, if it was like me and Mike or me and Bridget. I would take my closest ally to the end every day of the week.
Yeah.
But in that situation, I don't know why he did it.
I'm sure you've had a lot of time to reflect on how this game ultimately panned out. In the beginning, the first week, Frank, we were all thinking, oh, my God, Frank's going to win.
Yeah.
It's a runaway. Frank was just like you won week one like 52-0.
Yeah.
And it's like you're off to the races, but then very quickly it started to fall apart, and then it seemed like you were almost able to pull up out of the nosedive.
Almost, Frank.
So when you look back, where did you go wrong?
Honestly, Rob, I got impatient.
Yeah.
You know, those first couple weeks, man, they are so slow. And I was so ready to play the game, man.
99
I was just
days.
Like, you know, I love, you know, exactly. And that's what I needed to tell myself. We got 99 days in this dang house.
Yeah.
And I played a little too hard, a little too fast. I was just ready to get things moving, and I got them moving. It's moving too fast, and eventually I shot myself in the foot.
Yeah. What were some of the things that you took away from Big Brother 14 that you attempted to implement in this game?
You know, that's a good question, but, like, you know, one thing I think you saw, like, I had Mike in season 14, and I had one ride or die. And I pretty much did the same thing this season whenever I found Bridget. Now, that kind of hurt me a little bit because some people got a little butt hurt whenever they weren't my ride or die.
Yeah.
But,
like,
you know.
Who, like Big Meech?
Yeah, maybe like Big Meech, yeah.
I had no idea that was like a whole thing where it was like Big Meech hated Bridget, and we were like, why does she hate her? Well, the eyebrow thing? That's such a crazy thing. And then it turned out like, no. I wanted to be Frank's best friend.
Yeah. Well, I knew. I told her. I said, look, I was like, I know you're upset that I'm friends with her. Yeah. But I was like, I told her one time, I was like, that's immature. And she's like, I agree, but that's just the way it is.
That's
I was like,
the way
well,
it is.
What am I going to say?
What are you going to say? Did you feel like that Bridget got a raw deal when she went out in the double eviction? I couldn't believe that they knocked her out when she was sitting next to Big Meech in that double eviction.
I was really surprised about that, too. You know, I was like, at that point, you know, she didn't really have a whole lot of people in the house. So why send her home? And I was really hoping she was going to squeak by that week and then maybe another week. And the next thing you know, she's at the end of the game because obviously that's who I wanted to win.
Now, the way that Bridget ended up getting into the altercations with Paulie in the house and in the jury house, does that change your relationship with any of the people that get into altercations with her?
You know, Paulie and I, you know, even though we didn't really have any beef in the house, I know now after the fact that the guy was always, you know, really lying to my face and
not always working with
me.
You, yeah.
So, I mean, it didn't really change anything about Polly, you know. But, you know, as far as, you know, everybody else, you know, it's all water under the bridge.
Yeah. I feel like that you're somewhat of a reclusive character from Big Brother in terms of that, you know, you're here. When you're here, you're here. But when you're not here, you're not super into it. Is that a misconception?
You know, it's not. You know, I'm kind of a private guy. You know, I'm not a big social media buff guy.
Yeah.
I don't really do. My mom's always mad at me because the only thing I ever post pictures of is what I'm eating for dinner. You know, so it's like, but I don't.
And Game of Thrones.
Oh, yes. Game of Thrones. You know, I love Game of Thrones.
Yes.
And but I don't know, man. I think part of what it is I just see all these people, you know, who maybe try to hang on to that 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And for me, it's like, I love, it's fun being on here and doing this, but it's not about being on TV. It's about the fun of the competition, because that's what I love. I'm a competitive guy, and coming out here competing, and that's what I like to come out here. It's like I come out here, do my thing, and I just go back home, and I kind of stick to myself.
And so when you're not doing Big Brother, what is your thing?
What do you mean? Just like in general?
Yeah, I feel like I don't really know, other than I know who your dad is, and I know you play Big Brother, but outside of that, I feel like I don't know too much else about you.
You know, man, I'm kind of a recluse, believe it or not, and I think that's why I do okay in the house, because I'm good at being stuck between four walls, but I'm kind of a recluse. I'm a little bit of a hermit, you know? I love going to have a good dinner. I like to go out and have a nice dinner every once in a while, but other than that, I'm always vegging on the couch watching some TV.
Yeah, here's where I think you got screwed this season, Frank, also. So they had this battle back, and it was, what was it? It was the week after. You were there when Victor came back.
Yep.
And then you were gone, and then they had another battle back that came after.
And all the care packages. I missed all that, yeah. But I went home on the bubble. I went home on that one week where there wasn't a battle back. And that hurts, you know. But, hey, I know it wasn't personal. You know, it's just the way the game played.
Yeah. All right. Well, Frank, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too, Rob, man.
All the best to you, and good to see you.
Absolutely.
All right, we're here with Zakiya. Zakiya, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yes. All right.
Has a podcast.
That's me. Now, you ended up voting for Nicole, and
yes.
I wasn't surprised by your vote for her, because I feel like you don't like Paul.
No, I love Paul.
I felt like that. There was some tension there.
No, he's...
There's some friction.
No.
Yes.
I love Paul.
Yes.
Oh, you want me to say, I didn't like Paul. No,
yeah,
I love Paul.
Yeah, that's fine. I can say that. Well, it's a different Paul. I probably want to ask you more questions about.
Yeah.
So the Paulie thing was so, it was on again. It was off again.
Yeah.
He got to the jury house.
Yeah.
You said he was a loser.
Yeah, I said that.
I think you said something else.
I called him a bitch too.
Yeah, bitch.
Yeah.
You called him bitch. but then we said, oh, okay, that's it. He's done now. Zakiya's done with him. But then the next time we saw it, it was like, okay, me and Zakiya, we got everything patched up now. And wait till my brother Cody meets her, Everything's gonna be good. Davon.
Who said that?
Yeah. No. So, but so what's going on now? So you guys are are back on.
We are cool, and we'll see what happens later on in life. I don't know.
Now, did ultimately this showmance cost you a friendship with Davon?
Possibly. I have no idea.
Yes.
I don't know. I feel like with true friendship, your friends are there to stay.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. So you feel like that your friends should like you no matter who you're seeing.
Yeah, they should love you and support you no matter what.
Yes.
Yep.
It really got very ugly, that whole scene at the jury house.
Yeah.
Where they got into a whole big fight.
Yeah.
And it was very distressing to watch.
Yeah.
So how were things after that?
I spoke to everybody. I talked to everybody. I let them know, you know what, like, we should remain being classy and cute and get over it, and
But did things just get that hot because the cameras were on that day, or is it like that all the time?
In my opinion, yes, because it was the cameras. That's my opinion. Like, cameras, come on, it's one thing when they're off.
Yeah, everybody was, it was so it was much more calm when there weren't cameras on.
Oh, yeah, it was not like that.
Now, did you and Pauly ultimately both, like, talk about this vote, that it needs to be, it should be Nicole if she's up there?
No, we didn't even talk about it. We couldn't talk about it, so it was kind of interesting that we both ended up voting that way, so,
How come you didn't have a question for the jury? How did they decide that who was going to ask the questions?
We all decided at once, like, who was going to ask questions, what questions are going to be asked. So it was all our decision.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. So now we're from here. Mm-hmm. You and Pauly are you officially? We want to know this, Zakiya.
Yeah.
That are you officially dating now, or is it like he's going to go back to Jersey and then you guys will be like long distance?
I don't know yet. I have no idea. I wish I had an answer for you. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know.
Boy, Zakiya.
I'm killing you right now.
Yes. Yes. I don't know what to say.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say. you know, that this showmance.
Yeah.
I mean,
you know, it's that's bae. That's bae.
That's bae.
Yeah.
That's bae. All right. And then we just can't understand.
Yeah. I gotta understand first.
You gotta understand. And then we can understand what you're doing.
Yep.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right. Are you looking forward to going back and watching the episode?
I'm not gonna do that
anytime
soon.
No.
No.
Yeah.
I don't wanna see any of that.
I'm
not ready.
Okay. So in terms of the final three that was there, was Nicole your ultimate pick?
Oh, yeah.
Or you pro James?
Yeah, no matter what, I knew I was gonna vote for Nicole. So it was a done deal.
Yeah.
Nicole's my girl, so
How did your relationship with Big Meech end up working out? Because in the house you guys were very close.
Yeah.
Especially when Davon went out, you guys were weren't in the loop on that.
Yeah.
And then were you guys able to stay friends in the jury house throughout the Pauly thing? Or did it turn into that it was like she was team Davon?
It was kind of honestly like the girls against me and Pauly. But I still remain cordial with the ladies. I don't know if they care for me too much, but it is what it is. Like,
did you ever get into it with them? Did you ever, or was it always Pauly fighting them?
It was always pretty much Pauly fighting, like the girls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I hope everybody can end up getting along.
Oh, yeah.
Of course. Are you going to watch BBOTT?
I probably will.
Yes.
Yes.
So do you want to campaign for Jose to get back into the house?
I don't know yet.
Yes. Why? You're not pro Jose?
I know he's entertainment.
You were part of Big Sister with Jose.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll probably watch. I'll campaign for him. Why not?
Tell people. Why should people vote for Jose to get back in the house?
You guys should vote for Jose to get back in the house because good entertainment. The guy's funny.
Yeah.
Why not?
Would you ever want to play Big Brother again, or you had your fill and that's it?
I have to think about that maybe after tonight, and then
you have to think about everything.
I do. Like,
you have a lot to think about.
I do.
Zakiya.
There's just so much that's going on right now. This is like a crazy night. So
okay. Well, it's very nice
all
to
right,
meet
thank you.
I wish all the best for you.
Thank you, Rob.
And nice to meet
nice
you.
Nice to meet you. Okay. Thank you so much.
All right, everybody. We are here with Bridget, not a Cabbage Patch Kid.
Not literally.
So it's so nice to hear from you. We didn't even get to hear a question from you in the finale.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there's only six of them.
We did hear from you in the jury house. You became very outspoken, Bridget. You were so nice and sweet in the beginning, and then you really were like, all over Paulie. In the house, and then ultimately in the jury house.
Yeah.
That's fine. That's fine. And you shouldn't. You shouldn't have any regrets. So talk to me about what that was like in terms of how your relationship ultimately was in the jury house with him.
Yeah. Relationship in jury house with Paulie was so awkward. It was super awkward.
Super awkward.
Yeah, we were just basically avoiding each other, and you know, he walked around like this, and I, you know, just whatever.
Do you feel like that there is an issue with the way that he talks to women?
Honestly, I do. From the evidence that I've seen, but at the same time, Big Brother's a massive pressure cooker, and exaggerations of personalities come out. So
you can forgive him.
Whew. I forgive him. I will never forget.
Will not forget.
I hope and pray that.
But what does this go back to? Is this to going back to what was said about Natalie in the house, or is this going back to stuff with Davon or with Zakiya?
It goes. It stems from what he said to Natalie, and
then
from that, I defended Natalie, and then how he treated myself, Natalie, and Michelle in that house.
Because I believe he was very offended that you charged him with these accusations.
Well, I think he needs to go back and watch the season himself.
I believe at one point he said that you would have to be able to one day explain to whatever God-type thing you believe in for forgiveness for this.
Me?
Yes.
Okay, thanks, Paulie.
Yes.
Whatever.
Well, hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully you'll find
he does
forgiveness.
The same, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, I forgive. I never forget.
Okay. Talk to me about Mr. Jenkins and what was going on, because that became sort of like your thing in the house.
I love my basil plant.
Yeah. Why were you feeding him people food?
Honestly, the Big Brother gets really lonely, especially after Frank was evicted.
Yeah.
He was my best friend in the house. And I had that stigma following me around as a target. People are afraid to hang out with you. I don't like eating by myself, so I started eating with my friend, Jenkins.
When Natalie left, she took Mr. Jenkins out of the house.
I was so happy.
And then he's safe now?
He's safe, yeah.
And you're going to take him home?
Oh, yeah.
Can you take him on a plane?
I drive. I'm from California.
Okay, great.
Yeah, no worries there.
Perfect. All right, and then where does the name Mr. Jenkins come from?
You know, Frank and I came up with it together.
Yeah.
I came up with Jenkins, and he came up with the nickname Jinx.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
You cast your vote for Paul tonight,
I did,
correct?
Yeah.
Was it close for you? I didn't know how you were going to vote.
Dude, I didn't know either.
Yeah.
I didn't decide until I was standing at the podium. Both are really great contestants. I just felt that Paul played more game.
Yeah.
Nicole's final speech, she said she didn't have to start playing until like day 58. And for that reason, I gave it to Paul.
Do you feel like that Paul should have taken James to the end?
100%. Oh. I feel like that was a $500,000 mistake, to be honest.
100%. Yeah.
But I think that he made the wrong decision there. But
yeah. So, and you would have voted for Paul over James?
Yes, 100%.
Because I felt like that you were tight with Natalie by proxy through James.
Yeah.
But you still would have voted for Paul.
100%.
Friendship.
Yeah, friendship.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Jose is in the mix for BBOTT.
I heard.
Yes.
How exciting.
Yes, exciting. All right. Can you make the case? Why should people vote for Jose? Why should they vote for the Messiah?
I hope that he doesn't go with that for too much longer.
Look, the Messiah, he...
Yeah,
but yes, it's a big thing.
Jose.
He's the Messiah of the newbies.
Oh,
he was
God.
He his game died, and he might be resurrected again.
My case for Jose is that you will absolutely have entertainment. That guy is a joy to hang out with. He's so much fun. I can't wait to party with him after this.
Friendship. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, that Paul should have taken James. Jose should get back in the house.
Yeah.
Mr. Jenkins is going to be fine.
I'm going to buy him a bigger pot.
And you and Paulie are civil, but there's some healing that still needs to be done.
I don't need to know this man.
Yeah. How excited were you to see Frank again?
I was so excited.
Yeah.
Honestly,
what did you say to him?
I just gave him a big hug. Just miss you, dude. I truly did.
How on earth did these house guests vote you out when you're sitting up there on the block with Big Meech?
Yeah.
And what did she say? She's like, Nicole, you're a snake. Pauly, you suck. Like, yep. Yeah. And they voted you out.
I've been trying to figure that out, to be honest. I think that I showed my cards as a strategist to James, which was a bad idea. I also showed Paul that, you know, I had Natalie with me and not with James.
Yeah.
And for that, I think James must have had something to do with it, but I still have to ask him.
Yeah.
So,
all right.
Whatever.
Well, Bridget, really nice to meet you.
Yeah.
You're
nice
so sweet.
Thanks.
You seem like such a nice, genuine person.
Thank you.
You have no business being in this house. You seem so nice.
Thank you.
You seem so nice. How's your ankle? Everything is good?
It's getting better. It's still achy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I call it my old man ankle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I Frank apologized for that.
That was
way
times.
Too rough what he did. All right. Well, Bridget, thank you so
thank
much.
You.
Really appreciate it, and all the best to you and Mr. Jenkins.
Thank you so much. Okay.
All right, we are here in the Big Brother backyard with Tiffany Russo. Tiffany, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Very good. Very nice to see you in person.
Thank you.
And we'd just love to get your take on this final two. If you had a vote, would you have voted for Nicole to win? I know you guys were part of the...
Freakazoids.
Freakazoids. Also, the Fatal Five. Right.
Eight pack.
Yeah, you're in so many alliances together.
Yeah. No, I would have. I would have voted for her, for sure. And not just because of that. I respect her gameplay.
Yeah, over Paul's.
Yeah.
Did you have a strong relationship with Paul in the house at all?
No.
No.
Definitely not.
All right, so you definitely were in favor of it. Were you happy to see a woman beat a man in the
definitely,
final two
yes.
for the first time?
For sure, yes.
Yes.
That was awesome.
Yes. So then take us through as you were watching the rest of the season unfold. You know, I was talking with Devon about how there was so much friction between you and Frank and Devon. And then that was like a whole nother world that happened after all three of you guys ended up out of the house. Did you have any sense of that there was going to be some sort of just collateral damage with the three of you and then everybody else was going to be able to have like a end run?
You know, it's hard to say. It just things flip on a dime in that house. You don't really know what's going to happen from week to week. I was surprised with some things I saw, for sure.
So talk to me about, do you feel like that you were unfairly targeted in this game? Because you came into this almost like where Willie Hance, Russell's brother, came in. And then he was like a lunatic.
Yeah.
And probably was rightfully targeted.
Yes.
That you ended up getting a lot of stuff thrown at you
for
because
sure.
of Vanessa's game.
Because of somebody over there, right here.
Yeah, yeah, this guy.
It's just people really, you know, they thought because I sound like my sister, I kind of look like her, that I was her, but I really wasn't. I was playing, I was low key. I wasn't being strategic in that. I was trying to really lay it low.
Like, oh my God, it's so Vanessa. Can't you see it? Yeah.
Definitely not.
Yeah, that was what it was like. So when you got out of the house, what did Vanessa say about how everything went?
You know, she was proud of me. We talked about my gameplay, the things that were like, you know, things I could have done differently, things that I did right, you know, overall, just all of it. And she's proud though.
We were so convinced that you were gonna come back in the battle back competition.
Oh, I know.
That you had that one competition against Victor. And again, this was before we really knew we thought of Victor as Elfitvic, Comp Beast Victor.
Oh yeah, I knew though, yeah.
But it looked like when you guys were doing the puzzle, what was it like up there? You guys are doing this puzzle, and it looked like that he wasn't paying attention to any of the announcements that were going on.
Yeah.
You were. Looked like you had a system.
Yeah.
And then it was like a big upset that he pulled it off.
Yeah. I know. It came down to just being physically exhausted, and he was able to maneuver around that thing like a freaking monkey, and I was like not
right
there.
Right. Of the people that were left in the house, who were you really pulling for? Was it Nicole? Was that would have been your number one pick?
I mean, just strictly on like gameplay and how they played, I was rooting for her game, you know? But overall, I was rooting for Victor as like, you know, we wanted Vic to go far. Like, I feel like America wanted Vic to win, you know?
Yes.
It's hard not to root for him.
So as somebody who was watching the show play out, what were some of the things that really caught your attention that you couldn't believe were happening in the second half of this game?
Oh, gosh, just like the whole Pauly mess. Like, that was crazy,
that
right?
That was
like a lot. Just all of it.
Which part? The whole in the house or in the jury house?
Literally all of it.
What's the relationship like at this point?
With who?
With Pauly.
And who?
You.
Oh, we're fine.
You're fine.
Yeah, we're fine. That was all gameplay. We never had a personal issue with each other.
Any animosity with anybody from this cast or it's all good?
No. Nothing's, Even with like Devon or any of them. Yeah,
tell me, will you be coming back to play in Sequester All-Stars?
Sequester. Oh, like Sequester? Sequester? Yes. Like Audrey
Sequester? The game.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't know you knew about that.
Yes,
yeah,
yeah. Yes. For sure. Try to be a professional. Yeah. Do all my research on this stuff.
I will. I think so. She wants me to.
Yeah. Are you excited for the OTT?
Yes. It'll be fun. It'll be cool.
Now, do you think that Jose should get back into the house? You have Jose, who played with you.
I love Jason.
And Jason, who played with Vanessa.
I know Jason. But, you know, Jose would actually be so entertaining. So it's like, am I going to want to go for someone who I'm like, I really like, is my friend?
Yeah.
Or somebody who would be super entertaining. I don't know.
Yeah, it is a real tough decision. I would rather hang out with Jason outside of the house.
Yeah, yeah.
But I feel like I might rather watch Jose on my TV.
But I want Jason to win, or my computer.
Jason.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know. It's a tough call.
Yeah.
What a time to be alive.
I know.
Yes. So nice to finally get to talk with you.
Thank you. Yes.
And if you're following this OTT, I'd love to hear what you have to say on the podcast as we go along.
Definitely.
Tiffany, so nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Take care. What'd you get from Big Jeff?
Okay, this was a stretch for him, but it was
Halloween
eyeballs because I wasn't seeing things clearly in the beginning of the game.
Yeah, boy. You wonder maybe if he's like in a hurry to just
like,
all right, I've only got 10 minutes.
What does this represent?
Okay. All right, well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, everybody, we're here in the backyard with Bronte. Bronte, how are you?
I'm so good, thank you. I've been enjoying summer out at the pool, like taking hikes, so I'm good, well rested.
Good. How was the experience coming back tonight?
It was surreal. I felt like I was going to go to my high school, like, 10-year reunion.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm nervous to see these people. They feel like strangers. But then the moment I saw them, I was like, oh, family.
How did you feel about the outcome of wishful thinking of Nicole winning over Paul?
I was a little shocked. I thought Paul would win over anyone.
Yeah.
I think Paul would have definitely won over James. But I was all about girl power since the beginning. So I'm thrilled that Nicole broke this record and beat a boy for the first time. So I'm happy for her. She did great.
If you had a vote, you would have voted for Nicole?
I think I would have voted probably for Paul.
Okay. Oh.
You know,
I thought you were girl power.
I am girl power, but Paul had such an uphill battle that it was hard not to want to vote for him.
Yes.
But Nicole, she deserves it too. I think they both deserved it, to be honest with you.
Yes.
Nicole did great.
Because you guys were all part of the resistance early on in the game,
yes.
Week 1. And
who
it was the
knew?
Six of you. And look at Paul. He made it all the way to the end.
I know. A resistance actually won. That's shocking. He knew how to get out of bad situations. He could talk. That boy could talk.
Yes. Were you sad at how the Spy Girls ultimately panned out?
Yeah, the Spy Girls diminished. I was hoping one of us would be at the finale.
Yeah.
So I am bummed, but, you know, it was hard. It was hard. I think Natalie trusted James more than she should have.
Mm-hmm.
If Natalie had played more of her own game, she would have made it a lot farther.
What went on back in the battle back? You had a mental competition against Victor.
Yeah.
We all thought that you were going to be able to smoke Victor in the mental competition. What happened, Bronte?
I was tired, to be honest with you. It was pretty late at night. I had slept 3 hours. I was exhausted. I didn't have what it took. He was ready. He had been waiting, you know, to play that. He was prepared. I found out about it last minute. So, yeah, he was destined to get back in the house. It was destiny.
Okay, real quick, Bronte. 9 times 9 is what?
81.
Yes, yes.
Woo-hoo!
All right.
I'm not as nervous as I am with Jess Schroeder.
Yes. Oh, well, that's like an insult.
No, but I was waiting for him all day. I saw him, and I just blinked.
Yeah.
But it's 81, America.
Are you going to watch Big Brother OTT?
Oh, yes.
Really?
Especially because Jose might be on it.
Yes.
So I'm
All right,
totally...
give people the pitch. Why should Jose go back into the house?
I think he's so fun to watch.
Yeah.
If anything, he might not be great at the game, but he is so entertaining. For that reason alone, put the boy on.
Put him on.
Put
All
him
right.
on.
Bronte, what are you doing after Big Brother?
I'm going to finish my degree. I want to be a mathematician. That's what I'm going to work towards.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, Bronte, so nice to meet you.
Thank you.
And all the best to you.
Thank you.
Okay, take care. Bye. All right, everybody. We are here with the great Glenn.
Hey, what's up, everybody?
Glenn. What happened? They picked Jose to go in the mix for OTT? Where's your shot?
Can you believe it? Bigger and better things probably.
Glenn,
have to be about.
Who do we have to talk to around here? Who do we have to talk to get Glenn on the OTT?
Right there, Miss Julie Chan, right?
Yes, she made the call. She made the call. Do you want Jose to get back in?
Yeah,
fellow newbie?
Not? Yeah, why not? I you know, he was on my season. I liked him. He's a good guy. He's a little over the top, so maybe that's
Yeah,
why.
That's why.
Yeah.
That's right. So tell me, you said the first time through you didn't get to meet Julie. You got to meet her tonight.
Yes, she came up to me and she said I wanted to say hi and all that. So she was very gracious. It was great.
Okay. If you had a vote tonight, you would have voted for
my
your boy. Yes.
Paul.
Yes.
I'm shocked.
Yeah.
I'm really shocked. I couldn't believe that that's the way it went.
Yeah. Just to make sure we keep that microphone close. We got to be able to hear you, Glenn.
Yes.
So that, do you feel like Nicole is a worthy winner?
No.
No? Okay, why?
No, I think Paul's game was a lot better than hers.
Yes.
He was on the block more. He talked his way off. He showed the true meaning of what you had to do to be a winner. You know, I thought she just wrote it out too much.
Yeah. So
I love her. Don't get me wrong. She's a sweet girl. But
you have no hard feelings.
No. But I think Paul played a much better game.
What about James? Do you think that James should have been in the mix for...
Shouldn't even been there.
Yeah.
He should have been gone a long time ago.
Yeah, why?
Same thing. They just floated around. He was more worried about being with Natalie than being on the game.
Yeah, okay. Take us through this whole process. So you watch the show with the family?
I watched it with family, friends, basically family.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I only watched it later. And I didn't go back to when I was, you know, losing with coconuts. So.
Yeah. And have you been talking with Jose? It doesn't look like he's in sequester or anything.
I was talking to him up to before we came, and then all of a sudden he disappeared. He wasn't with us the whole night.
Okay. Now, we're trying to get a Big Brother OTT podcast going in New York when we come in to do our live show.
Yes.
I hope that you can make it out there.
Yeah, definitely. Just let me know. As long as I get a little time in advance notice, I'm there.
Yeah, all right. So I got your info.
Yes.
I'll try to get you for that. Did they get your water bottle yet, Glenn?
No. They got nothing. I got a stupid
What do you have there?
A little...
This is... Show this on the camera. What is this?
A little wise remark about me losing the coconut challenge.
Oh, that's like your coconut guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, because Big Jeff gives out gifts for everybody.
Yeah, dollar gifts. The budget that they have here, you know, dollar gifts. But, hey, it's still all in good fun.
Yeah. Who are you most excited to see that now is out of sequester?
Paul and Victor.
Yeah.
Those are my guys. So, right away, I was really happy to see them, Natalie. You know, there was a bunch of them, but those guys I was tight with while I was in the house. So, you know, it was great seeing them.
Yeah. Well, Glenn, it's always great to see you. I hope we get to see you in New York next month when we do our live shows.
Yes, definitely.
And all the best to you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
See you soon, buddy.
All right, everybody. There you have it. That was the entire... I think we saw the entire cast of Big Brother 18, plus Julie Chen here, all from the Big Brother backyard. That's going to do it for BB18, but don't forget the BBOTT is right around the corner. You can get your live feeds for the BBOTT to start watching starting next Wednesday night, the 28th. Go to robinswebsite.com/live feed. So for me, it's about 10 after 11 here. Going to go home, get this video up. Hopefully that's what you're seeing. I did see Survivor, but probably got to check that out again because we've got our Survivor exit interview coming up on Thursday, plus our interview with Michelle Fitzgerald to recap the Survivor episode, plus voicemails with Kurt Clark. And then I'm also going to do a special feedback show all about BB18 one last time. That's going to be coming up on Friday. So if you have questions that you want us to answer on that show, email them into us, bigbrother@robhasawebsite.com. And of course, we do appreciate it if you subscribe to the YouTube channel and the podcast, robhasawebsite.com/iTunes. Also, we posted a behind-the-scenes video about everything I do at Rob Has a Podcast. If you want to check that out on our Patreon page and see more about the benefits of becoming a patron, you can see that at robhasawebsite.com/patron. So from outside of the Big Brother house, that's going to do it. Take care, everybody. Have a good one.